not mad at you, I'm just disappointed. When you were a kid, there were few things worse than hearing those words from your parents. Now I'm a grown man and a parent myself, and I know I would still hate to hear those words from my mom and dad. No matter how young or old you are, whether you're on the giving or receiving end of it, disappointment is something that no one wants to experience. We want to be happy and we want to make others happy, but that's not always how life works. We get let down and we let other people down. I remember as a new parent, the look on my son's face the first time I told him we were going to do something and then it didn't happen. That look of being mad and sad and disappointed is something I will never forget. Thankfully, God isn't like that. That can't happen to God because He already knew from the beginning of time what we would do. Listen to what it says in Jeremiah 1:5. Before I formed you, I knew you. Before you were born, I called you. I'm so grateful for this because I don't know about you, but for me, I've messed up a lot and I've given the Lord a ton of reasons to be disappointed in me. There's been times in my life where I have wondered if God even still loved me or if I was still called into ministry or if I was even still saved. And I'm pretty sure that if God were anything like us, He would just have that track on repeat. Todd, I'm not mad at you, I'm just disappointed. Oh man, I don't think I could take that. It would just eat me up inside. But I remember those words in Jeremiah. God knew from the beginning of time that I would sin, and yet He still chose me. He still called me. He still saved me all those years ago, knowing that I would sin. He isn't surprised by our sin. He isn't disappointed in us. He loves us in spite of our sin. But just because God knew we would sin, that doesn't make our sin okay. That doesn't give us a guilt-free pass to mess up again and again. Even if I knew my kids were going to mess up and do something wrong, that doesn't mean I don't want them to come to me and show me that they are sorry. Look at what it says in 1 Samuel 16:7. The Lord does not look at the things man looks at. Man looks at the outward appearance, but the Lord looks at the heart. It's our human nature that when we are wronged, we want to see that someone is sorry. We want to see the look of remorse on their face. But Scripture tells us that God doesn't care about that. He looks at your heart. He wants to see change from the inside out. So I want to encourage you today. Maybe you've been looking like you have it all together on the outside, but you've been fighting a raging battle on the inside. Maybe you've been struggling with something or feeling guilty about something. God loves you in spite of your sin, but you must have a heart of repentance. He knew you before you were born. He has called you, and He wants to bless you and use you in a mighty way.